Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the thermal bimetallic relays. As the name itself suggests, these relays work on heating effect of the current. Now under normal operating condition, when the rated current flows, then heat is not sufficient to bend the bimetallic strip. But when the fault occurs, then the heavy current will flow. As a result, the heat will increase and the bimetallic strip will bend so that the contacts of the trip circuit will close. So this is the basic principle. Let us study it in detail. Diagram shows the thermal bimetallic relays. So let us study what are the various parts of this relay. So this is the heating coil, which is getting the input from the current transformer, that is CT. Then this is our bimetallic relay. Here we have the relay contacts. Then there is one insulated contact arm, one spring, and the output is given to the trip circuit of the relay. Now under normal operating condition, the current which is sensed by the CT is normal, so the heat is not produced. But when the fault occurs, then due to the heavy current, the heat will increase. Now this temperature will be sensed by the heating coil. Because of the heavy temperature, the heating coil will heat the bimetallic strip. Now under normal operating condition, this insulated contact arm was held in the far away position from the relay contacts. But when the fault occurs, due to the heavy current, whatever heat is generated will cause bending of the bimetallic strip. Now as the bimetallic strip will bend, the spring will release its pressure, and because of this, the trip contact of the relay will close. So it will give signal to trip circuit, so it will close. Once the trip circuit closes, it will give signal to the circuit breaker, so the contacts of circuit breaker will open. So basically, this relay works on the heat which is produced due to the increase of the current under the fault condition. So thermal relays work on the principle of thermal effects of the electrical energy. The important parts of the thermal relays are, first is bimetallic strip. So as the name suggests, bimetallic strip is made up of two metals. Second is heating coil. Heating coil is used to sense the temperature. Next, current transformer. Current transformer will supply the current to the heating coil. Now, the current transformer supplies the current to the coil of the heater. Thermal energy of the heating coil heats the bimetallic strip. The bimetallic strip are made up of alloy of nickel and steel. Alloy of nickel and steel has high steel resistivity and also they are free from thermal aging. So the heat which is produced will induce very high thermal stress on the bimetallic strip. So the bimetallic strip should be made from the material which can sustain such high stresses. Hence it is made up from the alloy of nickel and steel. The insulated lever arm is connected to the trip coil along with spring and bimetallic strips. So spring will hold the insulated lever arm away from the trip circuit under normal operating condition. The tension of the spring is varied with the help of sector shaped plate. Now when the system is under normal operating condition, the spring will remain straight. But when the fault occurs on the system, the bimetallic strip gets heated and it will bend. So the tension of the spring will be released once the bimetallic strip is bent, and it will cause energization of the trip circuit of the relay. So the contacts of the relay energize the trip circuit, because of which contacts of the circuit breaker will close. Thus, the system will remain closed. The thermal relays are mainly used in, first, low voltage squirrel cage induction motor. Second, low output rating DC motor. The thermal relay has low overloading capability, so it is designed to operate 6 to 7 times more than the full load current. Such type of relay is not used under short circuit conditions. The short circuit current increases the temperature of the bimetallic strips. As a result, contacts of relay will close. The thermal relay is used with the short circuit relay or with the time limit fuse. So basically, thermal relay works on the principle of rise in temperature due to the rise in current under the fault condition. The bimetallic strip is made up of two elements, that is alloy of nickel and steel. As a result, when the heat is generated, the bimetallic strip will bend. Once the bimetallic strip will bend, the spring will release its pressure, so the trip circuit will close. In this way, we have studied thermal bimetallic relays. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekida and do subscribe our channel Ekida. Thank you.